My name is Mike Pritchard. I'm the Director of Climate Simulation Research at NVIDIA Earth-2. And I'm representing a team of really hardworking engineers that are trying to use AI across the Earth system modeling stack to improve how we, the accuracy of climate simulations and their relevance for society.
So yeah, Earth-2 is an initiative and a software platform that contains amazing new technologies for how to use AI to make climate predictions higher resolution, for how to do weather forecasts in a fundamentally new way that uses AI instead of physics, for energy efficiency, to unlock new types of data like huge ensemble weather forecasts that are relevant to calibrating our risk to future changes in climate. And so NVIDIA has cutting-edge AI algorithm research developers, and you can see evidence of their work in the public domain in things like video generation and image generation that use sophisticated modern diffusion transformers and other emerging AI architectures to do generative AI for video and image applications. And there's deep analogies between those applications and weather applications. You could kind of think of predicting the weather like predicting a video, where you try to take one frame of an image and predict the next image in a video using AI. So generative video is a mature technology. And the same kinds of algorithms can be used to predict, instead of images, weather states, which are kind of like images, but they have more than three channels. Instead of red, green, and blue, and instead of lots of statistical correlations between the colors, there's temperatures and winds and pressures at a given time. And we're trying to use AI, generative AI, just like the video prediction, to predict the next frame in the weather. And that's actually an act of learning physics with AI, because what you get at the end is a really big AI model that has not only learned to predict the atmospheric evolution, it's learned the physics of the atmosphere. And we know this because atmospheric scientists are taking these models and poking them and asking questions of their tests of learned physics and finding really satisfying answers that show there's a completely new way to simulate the atmosphere that doesn't involve writing down physics equations and discretizing them in code, but instead involves training big AI models on really good data. And that just changes everything.